Okay, so a warm good evening to everybody, all the students, and I want to place this in on record that thank you so much, ma'am, and of course the management of Matrix School for giving us opportunity and inviting us, me and my sir, like me and Avinash sir, Ashutosh sir, both of us, we will conduct lectures, and we will have I'll try to interact with you. Of course, the subject is known to you, that is, it is in your curriculum, and the subject code is 402. It is for semester 4, and the subject is Indian Ethos and Business Ethics. And of course, this is a compulsory generic course. So both of us, we will give whatever we know as per our knowledge and the information and whatever we have learned from our own experiences, our learnings, readings, and other things. So based on that, we will give you and guide you on this particular subject. So this is the subject, like it is there, it is mentioned in the syllabus. So I don't want to read it, but yes, I'll submit and I'll give my PPTs to you. I'll give all these PPTs and all this material to ma'am, and then probably she can forward these things to you. So these are the course outcomes, and this is about first topic. Totally, we have 5 topics. So 5 topics, and then about the first topic. This is the syllabus of first topic, and let us start then. Okay, are you ready? Yes, dear students, are you there with me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you so much. So this is the syllabus of first topic. Like here, under this subject or this topic, first we will try to understand the meaning of Indian ethos and values, right? And its relevance at workplace. Because probably when we will start and when we are interacting with you all, you might be thinking like, ma'am, this subject is more of philosophical and it is related to ethos, and we are talking about ethics and values and other things. Of course, yes. But I know that we all are management students, and then I need to connect Indian ethos or ethics or business ethics to the business ethics, probably the organization ethics, because as I said, that we all are management students. So I'll link everything to the business and organization. Don't worry about that. But yes, first few minutes or maybe few lectures, I can probably say that we will talk about and we will discuss about Indian ethos and ethics and values. And then probably we will shift, or slowly we can shift to business ethics, because it is there in your syllabus. So Indian ethos, the meaning, features, need, evolution, relevance, principle practice by Indian companies and requisites and elements are there. Then we can discuss about the role of Indian ethos in managerial practice. Then we will discuss something very interesting, one model, that is OSHA, OSHA model, or Triguna theory. So what is mean by that? So it is really exciting to know that what is mean by Triguna theory and what is mean by that, and how we can apply this to understand people personalities, and then we can correlate or we can use that information and knowledge when we are working in the organizations. Then after that, we will discuss something about work ethos, the meaning, dimension of work ethos, values, value concept, that what is mean by values, and what is mean by value system and value concepts and other thing, and how all these things are connected with business or business scenario. So that also we will discuss. And very important, we will try to learn the values, that is Indian ethos and Indian values, which are necessary for Indian managers. So that also, or what I mean to say, that we will try to establish a link between values, Indian values or Indian ethics, with the Indian managers or Indian organizations. Then relevance of value-based management in global change, that is again very important, because we all talk about India, everybody is talking about India, we are talking about Indian ethos, everybody considered it, like we have very good, cultural, or we are enriched by Indian culture and other things. So what is the role of this? Can I always have this question in my mind, can our Indian ethos, or the ethics which we believe on guide us as a professional in global world? Because we all know that global scenario or global environment is changing so fast. So kya hum log apne Indian ethic ke saath wahan pe survive kar sakte hai? Or can we say that Indian ethics are, you know, universal in nature? Can anybody and everybody accept those ethics or accept those, you know, are learning from our culture and Indian culture? So we will try to understand that. And impact of value on stakeholders, transcultural human values. As I said, like, okay, culture changes, geography changes, and ethics or ethical or ethos especially, it changes because ethos comes with, you know, culture. So first, slowly we will understand what is meant by Indian ethos or any kind of ethos and ethics, and what is the difference between ethics and ethos and other things. So ethics versus ethos, as it is written there, and very important, very, very important, because by now we are learning and we are discussing about the Western type of management. On all philosophies and theories, we are learning from Western management. Like, okay, Henry Fayol ne ye bola, this geography, this particular concept is given by this, and 14 principles and other things and other things. So we all know, because now you are in fourth semester and we all, you know, discuss a lot about Western management. But now onwards, from this class onwards, we will, you know, very few I don't know that how many students they are aware about Eastern management or not this kind of management and other things. So we will discuss this, and then probably we will you know, try to understand what is the difference between Eastern management and Western management. So let us move on. And you know, this is your syllabus, so I don't want to read your syllabus, because before each and every topic we will see and we will discuss about your, what is expected from that particular chapter. So let us move and discuss about the concept of ethos, you know. So this is very important, because we are talking about Indian ethos, but we will start from with the understanding of this particular term, that is ethos. Pehle hum log samajhte ki what is mean by ethos, and then we will move on and we will discuss about Indian ethos. And in third part, we will discuss about ethics, and then we will go for business ethics. So this is the flow of our discussion. Of course, I'll take three hours to discuss and complete our discussion on first topic. So what is the concept of ethos? So let us move. If you want to know the present, so it is very important to know the past or the history of anything. So ethos is a Greek word, and which roughly translates to the moral character of people or individual. So this is what a moral. So I'm expecting that this crowd or this class knows about moral, values, and ethos and ethics. So this is a rough, basic things like we must understand. So ethos means custom or character in Greek. Interesting. Like, what is mean by character? We all know that we are talking about the character sahi hona chahiye. Character is destiny. So likewise, when we are talking about character of individuals, at the and the similar part, there are, we can talk about or we can discuss about ethos or the characters of organizations. And not only that, but we can think about character of a country, character of that particular region, character of that particular geography. So ethos, why? Because in simple meaning, if you ask me, ma'am, ek simple line mein batao, bahut, matlab hum log fatak se samajh jaye. So iske liye main aapko bataungi ki ethos is a set of beliefs and ideas. Now, what is mean by belief? Belief is a strong value system of that individual. Beliefs, I repeat, beliefs is a strong value system of that individual. When I say that, okay, I believe on, and then slowly, because of my experiences, because of my life experiences, I slowly believe on those terms. Like, okay, I can give you one example here for more clarification. Like, if you feel like, okay, honesty is good one. It's a good character of an individual. If you want to become a successful person, if you want to become a successful professional, then you must be honest. Honesty is great value. So slowly, when you, you know, started doing that or started applying this concept or started applying this particular thought process into practice, aap dheere dheere usko practice karne lagte ho. And because of your experiences, because of your good experiences, because of your benefits and because of the gain which you have, you know, because of gain from your life or application of that particular concept, you feel like, okay, it's great, yeah, it work. And strongly, it becomes value of your life. Or this will become a core value of your life. And you strongly believe on. Because of your experiences, because you experience it, like if I'm honest, I'm getting what? Good returns. This is the thing which we all can believe on. This is what I believe. This is my value system. A deep-rooted something in your heart, mind, and soul. You strongly believe on that. So this is what your beliefs and ideas about life, ideas about the things which is there in your vicinity or there in your environment. It is maybe your personal life, maybe your professional life. So you accepted a certain kind of or certain pattern of social behavior. Since you learn it from your, you know, maybe from the society or the partners in the society, maybe they are your parents, maybe they are your teachers, maybe in your school, maybe your friends, your siblings. So we are learning from them. It's a social kind of learning. And then you start applying those concepts in your life. And then you get experience, good, bad, ugly. If it is good, then you those things you believe on. Aapko lagta hai ki haan bhai, honesty chalta hai. But if you don't believe, you know, if you are getting bad, results or not so good or not expected results, and then you start thinking, there is a question mark in your mind. Like, is it true? Is it really working? Can I apply these things? Is it workable? So these things happen. These things happen. But afterwards, after some time, and again, you need to rethink and you are started thinking about those. But in short, what is ethos? Ethos means a set of beliefs and ideas. Aapki value system. Jo aapko direction deti hai, aapke behavior ko direction deti hai, how you will behave in the society. So that is very deep rooted, very, very deep rooted. And then you are learning it from your culture. You are learning from your society or the partners of society or interaction with the society. So that is what ethos means. And it becomes your character. Slowly it becomes your character. After sometimes you feel and you believe like, I don't want to compromise on my ethics. I don't want to compromise on my value system. Because that is a very basic thing or basic threat or basic characteristic of you as an individual. So that is what beliefs or ideas. That is what means a guiding force within you, which will guide you, which will give you directions. And your behavioral action is based on that. So we can see the behavior. We can see your reactions. I can see. But if I want to know the reason besides your behavior, so I need to understand the value system or the beliefs or the ethos on which you believe. Because ethos, beliefs, value system, ideas of your life, now these are guiding force. And the person or the individuals, they don't want to change it very easily. Ethos cannot be changed. Ethics cannot be changed. Easily, unless and until something happened. And wo jo bola na, hila ke rakh dene wala. If you have that kind of experience which shatters you as an individual, and then in that condition, maybe probably you will think, are, main sahi soch raha tha kya? Whether I'm right, whether my values of my life is right. That is what ethos means. So ethos is made or used to refer to the practices or the values that distinguishes one person, organization, or society from others. And that's why you are different. It makes you different. You are unique because of you, this, because your value system or your beliefs are different. फॉर समबडी ऑनेस्टी इज द बेस्ट पॉलिसी, फॉर समबडी ऑनेस्टी अरे नहीं चलता आजकल की दुनिया में. देयर बिलीव्स, देयर वैल्यू सिस्टम, बट नो नो, आई मस्ट बी ऑनेस्ट, आई मस्ट बी राइट, आई मस्ट हेल्प अदर्स, एंड आई एम नॉट थिंकिंग आई शुड नॉट बी सेल्फिश. इट्स ओके, दैट इज योर वैल्यू सिस्टम विच मेक्स यू एज अ यूनिक पर्सन. आपको एक अलग इंसान बनाता है, एक यूनिक इंसान बनाता है. सो सी अगेन आई विल गिव something which is given by Oxford. So let us discuss that what Oxford said. So according to Oxford, the Advanced Learner's Dictionary, the meaning of ethos, according to the dictionary, that is Oxford Dictionary, that is ethos are the moral ideas and attitudes, very interesting, that belongs to a particular group or a society. Very, very interesting meaning of this. That is, ethos are moral ideas. What is right? What is moral? What is morality? What is right and what is wrong? What is right and what is wrong? So there are certain norms, we follow it, right? Where from where we learn, like what is right and what is wrong? What is the way, what is the appropriate way to live your life? So there are certain things, there are certain guidelines, or there are some directions we are getting. From what? From what? From the society, from our culture. So ethos, it is when we are talking about Indian ethos, to apna, if we consider India, fine, or their population, so we can talk about, or we can consider Indian ethos as the ethics or the value system which is appropriate, or the moral ideas and attitudes which are appropriate to India. That is what Indian ethos, like way of life. And in India, according to Indian culture, we feel like, okay, this is the right way of living your life, or this is a wrong, no, this is wrong, not acceptable at all, because our culture said this is right and this is wrong. So ethos are the moral idea. It is an idea. It is about the philosophy of life. It is an idea of life. It is an idea like what is right and wrong. And attitude. Hamara drishtikon kahan se aata hai? Our attitude is based on our culture. So it is that belong to particular group. So what we are here, we are talking about which group? We are talking about India. Indian. We all are Indians. And then we are thinking about this, that in India, or according to Indian culture, what is right and what is wrong? This is what we are talking about, or we can discuss, or we can understand Indian ethos means. Ek simple line mein aap puchoge, to Indian culture ke hisab se kya sahi hai aur kya galat? Abhi sahi galat kiske liye bol rahe? Aapke life jeene ka tarika. Your social interaction, your social behavior. So it is like, okay, you are dealing with people, you are interacting with people. So there are some ways, there are some means, there are something, some system is developed. You cannot, you cannot behave, because you are a social animal. We all are social animal. And then we are interacting, and our behavior is guided and regulated and controlled by our society. And it is written there. It is written there. Something is there in the chat box. Let me see what is there. Good evening, everybody. Sagar Telkar said, okay, good evening. So that is that. So it is an attitude. It is an moral idea about the way of life that belongs to the particular group and society. Today, ethos is used to refer the practices, as I said, or value system that distinguishes one person, organization, and society from others. We are different. Indian culture, India, is different from rest of the world. In India also, we have different parts, and in different parts, we believe on something. Our beliefs, our value system is something different. Our way of life is different. But if we are talking about overall India, it is same. It is not like, okay, north mein ye sahi hai to south mein galat ho gaya, south mein galat hai to matlab jo cheez galat hai wo north mein sahi hai. It's not like that. We are talking about the overall philosophy of Indian culture. We are talking about overall philosophy of India as a country. And we are talking about Indian culture here, and which distinguish India from rest of the world. Here we are talking about, okay, distinguishing one person, organization or society. Because har ek organization ka vision, mission alag hai. Unka value system alag hai. Unka belief system alag hai. So they believe, like some people, they said like, okay, we are there, we are serving for, we are, our whole existence is depend upon people. Agar log hai, mere log wahan pe appreciate karenge, if they accept my existence as an organization, so we can survive. So we are by the people and for the people. If that is your philosophy, definitely the whole, your business strategy and the whole goals and mission, vision, the way you are doing business and way you considering and interacting with the external world, this particular philosophy will guide you. So likewise, when we are talking about Indian ethos, so as a country, when we are interacting with people, or people from outside, any part of the world, we represent, we believe like, okay, we are Indians and this is my culture and I learn from culture. And according to my culture, this is right. This is the right way of doing things. And this is the wrong way of doing things. This is the right way of interacting with people. And this is a wrong way of interacting with people. This is a right way of dealing with people. And this is a wrong way of doing, dealing with people. So there are certain sets, there are some morale, some value system, some guiding forces there. And we are learning it. We are learning from the society. And it is very beautifully, somebody can believe in that is Indian culture is transformed from one generation to another generation. Those ethos or the value system is transformed from one generation to another generation. And then in this way, generation to generation, our learnings, our value system, our right or wrong, sahi galat, ये हम लोग आगे की पीढ़ी को अगले आगे वाले जनरेशन को भी समझाते हैं एंड पीपल दे लर्न सो दिस इज व्हाट यू नो इंडियन इथोस और इथोस मींस फाइन सो लेट अस डिस्कस द सेकंड टर्म व्हिच इज देयर इन योर सिलेबस एंड वी मस्ट नो अबाउट दैट दैट इज एथिक्स देयर आर टू टर्म्स वी आर डिस्कसिंग हियर दैट इज इथोस आई होप दैट इथोस इज वेरी क्लियर टू यू सो इथोस मींस नाउ व्हिच इज रिलेटेड टू one particular class, one particular group, a culture, a group ka culture, a society ka culture, a organization ka culture, or we can think about one person's culture. So it is like that. Ethos is related to one particular group. Then what about ethics? Ethics is a set of standard. So it's a science. नीति शास्त्र जिसको हम बोलते हैं और अ कोड ऑफ वैल्यू सिस्टम वर्कड आउट फ्रॉम द ह्यूमन रीजंस एंड एक्सपीरियंस बाय विच फ्री ह्यूमन एक्शंस आर डिटरमाइंड एज अल्टीमेटली राइट रॉन्ग गुड और इविल सो इथिक्स आर यूनिवर्सल इट्स नॉट रिलेटेड टू वन रीजन इट इज नॉट ओनली रिलेटेड टू वन कल्चर इट इज नॉट ओनली रिलेटेड टू वन ज्योग्राफिकल पार्ट Ethics are universal. ये भी यही बोल रहा है. Ethics are same. Like okay, ethics and ethos, both the things we are learning like from these two things. Like okay, what is the similarity between these two? That is, it is they are giving this. These are guiding forces, or which provides us direction that what is right and what is wrong, what is good and what is evil, what is ethical and what is unethical. सही गलत की पहचान कराते हैं. But then what is the basic difference between ethos and ethics? Ethics are universal. Ethics are ethics. We can't say like, okay, these are Indian ethics and these are not applicable in the rest of the part. No, ethics are universal. You go anywhere, you are dealing with people. Jo sahi hai, wo sabke liye sahi hai, aur jo galat hai, wo sabke liye galat hai. So ethics are more universal in nature. Then what is ethos? But fine. That, from that science, जो हम लोग बोलते हैं मैंने अभी आपको बताया कि it's a नीति शास्त्र. From that science, all culture are developed on the basis of this particular शास्त्र or this particular science, that is नीति शास्त्र. और उन्होंने अपने अपने हिसाब से जो अपने ज्योग्राफिकल लोकेशन को सूट करता है, विच इज सूटेबल टू दिस पर्टिकुलर ज्योग्राफिकल लोकेशन, एंड दे हैव यू नो दे हैव दे लर्न एंड दे प्रैक्टिस इट एंड दे एक्सपीरियंस इट एंड इट दे अडॉप्टेड दिस. So ethics are a bigger umbrella, and ethos, which are related to those specific regions, that is what we call, or regions or a group or individuals. So that is usme se thoda thoda cheez humne liya, aur jo hume applicable hai, which is for applicable or more suitable to that particular region or geography. So we have studied it, we have applied it, as I said, and then we experience it. जैसे मैंने बोला कि ओके वी लर्न फ्रॉम समथिंग एंड देन हम लोग उसको प्रैक्टिस करने लगे और प्रैक्टिस से हमें एक्सपीरियंस आया और एक्सपीरियंस से हमें रिजल्ट आया और रिजल्ट के बेस पे हम लोगों ने माना कि यस दिस इज वर्केबल, दिस इज राइट, दिस इज द राइट अप्रोच ऑफ डूइंग थिंग्स एंड देन वी अप्लाइड इट एंड इट बिकम्स अ पार्ट ऑफ आवर कल्चर. और जैसे मैंने बोला कि एंड देन स्लोली वी आर यू नो ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड ऑल दिस थिंग्स फ्रॉम वन जनरेशन टू अनदर एंड it is imbibed, it is there in our culture. That is what ethos means. Let us move to the next, that is, what is the difference of ethos and ethics? So I'll read it for you, that ethics is a discipline that examines one's morality or the moral standard of that particular society. Sorry. And whereas ethics means expected standard in terms of your personal and social welfare, which it includes honesty, morality, responsibility, and everything. So honesty is honesty. We can't say like, okay, we are out of India, so this is, if I behave in a certain way, it is honest. No, honesty is a universal character, which is applicable everywhere in the world. But ethos, which is, of course, honesty, which comes under ethos also, but if it is applicable, accepted by your culture, then it becomes ethos. Matlab, honesty to hai. Honesty to sab jagah hai. Honesty is one good quality or good, something good that everybody should follow. And the application of this particular honesty, morality, or responsibility is similar. Sab jagah same hai. But when it comes to India, if it is, we are accepted that, we are accepted it and or it is there in our culture, accepted by our culture, so it becomes ethos. So agar aapko samajhta hai aur agar aapko koi poochta hai ki what is the difference between ethos and ethics, so it is first thing or we must understand it is a way of life. It is like, okay, it is which gives you direction. जो आपको डायरेक्शन देता है, किस बारे में, किस चीज के लिए डायरेक्शन देता है, दैट व्हाट इज राइट एंड व्हाट इज रॉन्ग, व्हाट इज इथिकल एंड व्हाट इज अनएथिकल. एंड इथिक्स आर यूनिवर्सल इन नेचर, सब जगह सही सेम ही है. और इथोस दैट ओके व्हिच इज एप्लीकेबल टू वन रीजन, वन ज्योग्राफिक रीजन, वन कल्चर, वन सोसाइटी, वन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. सो दैट इज व्हाट इथोस मीन्स. लेट अस मूव टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट एंड डिस्कस समथिंग अगेन. सी the difference, the basic difference. So origin kya hai ethics and ethos bhi, jo maine abhi bataya. Ethics are derived from shastra and that's why they are universal. Ethos are derived from culture, because we know that Indian culture is different from Japanese culture, or Japanese culture is different from some other country's culture. Why they are different? Because they have accepted certain things, they have experienced certain things or applied and experienced certain things, and they are the some results they have mentioned, or they have experienced some results, bad, good, based on their actions, and then they accepted as a value system, that is a part of the value system, part of their value system. So it will become part of their culture. So ethos is derived from the culture, whereas ethics are derived from the shastra, niti shastra. Niti shastra, sahi galat, or that is universal. Here, culture specific region or country. So religion, region, country, culture. So there are some differences there, not much, but yes, there is certainly we are different, or Indian culture or any kind of culture, they are different from each other. Like hamara welcome karne ka tarika, like okay, we say good afternoon, no, namaste. Some people, they said good afternoon, good morning or something. So that is our culture. It is their culture. And then according to the culture, see, I repeat, please try to understand, according to the one, any specific culture, what is right and what is wrong, they have their own concepts. That is because that is imbibed, that is a part of their value system, and it becomes ethos. So universal and cultural, you know, specific functions. Since it is derived from Niti Shastra, so ethics are determined like paap, punya, swarg, narak, conduct or misconduct, or ethical and unethical, right, wrong. And here we are talking about determines the culture or cultured behavior. According to my culture, according to Indian culture, according to my religion, you know, this is not done. ये हमें स्वीकार नहीं, ये हमें मंजूर नहीं, this is not right, this is wrong, this is unethical. What is the base for that? Like, okay, my culture, our culture, that kind of thinking. Fine. So example is truth, non-violence, devotion, kindness is extra. So it is universal. Truth is truth. अगर ज्योग्राफी बदल जाएगी, एरिया बदल जाएगा, कल्चर बदल जाएगा, तो झूठ सच झूठ नहीं होएगा, सच सच ही होता है, झूठ झूठ ही होता है. नॉन वायलेंस, यस, मानवता जिसको हम लोग बोलते हैं, डिवोशन, काइंडनेस, दीज आर यूनिवर्सल वैल्यूज, दीज आर यूनिवर्सल बिलीव्स. एंड व्हाट अबाउट यू नो इथोस? As I said, like, okay, the way we do welcome, pranam, respect to elders, love to youngsters, and other things. Though it is a part of ethics, but we have some particular kind of, way of doing that. Because we say, in our culture, it is like this. We do pranam, we do namaste. This is what my culture is. And according to my culture, if you behave like this, it is wrong. Because it is not accepted in Indian ethos. This is not my culture. This is not our culture. So ethos is based on culture. Ethics are based on shastra. Aur kaun sa shastra hai? Niti shastra. Let us move on. Let us discuss further about Indian ethos. Abhi thoda sa samajhne ki koshish karte bhai. Ma'am to itni der se bol rahe ki ma'am Indian ethos. What is Indian ethos? What is Indian culture? Fine. So let us try and find out that what is mean by Indian ethos. So Indian ethos is all about what can be termed as a national ethos accepted by each and every person, each and every individual who belong to this country, who belong to this culture. So that is what Indian ethos. हम लोग ये नहीं बोल सकते कि since I belong to this region and I belong to that religion, so Indian ethos are not applicable to me. No, it's not like that. It is applicable to you irrespective of your region, religion, caste, whatever, age and everything. It is accepted by everybody. So Indian ethos refer to the principles of self-management, very interesting, and governance of society, entity or a system by wisdom. Very interesting, as I said. I said, like, ma'am, you might be thinking, like, ma'am, khud hi bole ja rahi hai ki interesting. No, it is really interesting. But hum log agar bolte ki what is ethos or what is Indian ethos, so we are referring or we are discussing about the self-management and governance of society. Hum apne aap ko kaise manage karenge? Hum apne society ko kaise govern karenge? Kaise chalayenge? क्या सही है मेरे सोसाइटी के लिए, क्या गलत है मेरे सोसाइटी के लिए? सोसाइटी लाइक पीपल इन दिस हु दोज हु बिलोंग टू दिस पर्टिकुलर कंट्री. एंटिटी और अ सिस्टम, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ सिस्टम इज एप्लीकेबल, एक्सेप्टेबल टू दिस पर्टिकुलर रीजन और दिस पर्टिकुलर कल्चर कॉल्ड इंडियन और इंडिया. So, इसके लिए क्या सही है, क्या मानते, कैसे मानते, what we believe on, what is our belief system, what is our value system, किसके लिए? Self management के लिए. किसके लिए? Governance of the society के लिए. और it is this system by wisdom, It is based on our wisdom. It is based on experiences of our forefathers. ऐसा नहीं है कि चलो कुछ भी मन में आया और हमने उसको accept कर लिया. No. As I said, like, okay, when you listen, when you observe something or when you experience something, आप उस किसी चीज को experience करते हो और फिर बाद में slowly you believe on that. वो आपकी value system बन जाती है. आपका जीवन जीने का तरीका बन जाता है. So likewise, our forefathers, हमारे जो forefathers है, हमारे gurus है, उन लोगों ने कुछ तो मतलब बहुत सारा research किया और they, you know, based on their wisdom and based on their experiences, this particular concept of Indian culture or this particular concept of Indian ethos has emerged. And that's why I said, like, yes, it is really very interesting to know that what is mean by Indian ethos. Because it is based on some wisdom, somebody's wisdom, not only one person's wisdom. Like, okay, there are so many people, they have contributed for the development of this particular culture. So wisdom as revealed and brought forth. Kisne ye laya? By great scriptures like Veda, Upanishad, Gita, Mahabharat, Bible and Quran. These are scriptures. So, kisne likha? Gurus. Who is guru? Like, who knows? Who has that wisdom? Who has that vision? Like, meri society kaise honi chahiye? How? What is the right thing? Or what is the ethical way of doing things? Jeevan jane ka tarika kaise? Kaun sa sahi tarika hai? In logon ne bahut sara socha. In logon ne bahut sara. We can, in modern terms, we can say that yes, these people, they have done a lot of research. And they developed something. That is Veda, Upanishad, Gita, Mahabharat. Why we are talking about this and Bible and of course Quran. So these people, and what is there in these, you know, scriptures? They are these granthas or these granthas or whatever the scriptures, they are giving us direction. वो अपने को बताते कि भाई life कैसे जीना चाहिए, क्या सही है, क्या गलत. So it is based on wisdom and it is evolved through the old practices of Indian minds, philosophers and religious gurus. इन लोगों ने किया है, ऐसे ही नहीं बना. And for that, these people, they have, as I said, like, they have done some research, they applied it, they tested it. So these things or this gyan or this knowledge is tried and tested by these people that a lot of philosophers, like a lot of, you know, religious gurus, they have contributed and they use their wisdom, they use their experience to, and these things are evolved. And this, as I said, it is written there that it is now found to have profound implications of self-management and good governance. Governance management, how to govern, how to manage, of a stormy society and a business environment, or even a politically divided world. They are timeless. ये नहीं था कि लाइक ओके फाइन इट वॉज एप्लीकेबल इन दैट एरा, नाउ इट इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल. नो, इफ यू लर्न ऑल दिस, यू नो, इफ यू स्टडी एंड इफ यू नो अ बिट अबाउट दैट नॉलेज, यू हैव विद दैट अथॉरिटी, आई कैन से लाइक यस, इट इज, दिस नॉलेज इज टाइमलेस, बियॉन्ड एवरीथिंग, बियॉन्ड नो ऑल द बाउंड्रीज. इट इज नॉट रिलेटेड, इट इज, यू नो, इट इज रिटन देयर वेरी लास्ट टू words, that is politically divided world. We are living in this particular era that we are divided, or these countries are different parts of countries, they are divided because of politics. But can we apply this knowledge? Can we apply, or can we, or should we follow that Indian culture or Indian ethos? Yes, of course, yes. Then you might be thinking like, okay, madam is talking about Gita, madam is talking about Upanishad and other things. So it is a body of knowledge. This is a body of knowledge. As I said, like, we learn, we are getting information and knowledge from all the scriptures. And this particular knowledge is derived, its solutions from the rich and huge Indian system of ethics. That is our moral philosophy. very special kind of knowledge derived, and this is very rich and huge. And then we have created an Indian system. See, system, we know organization systems and other things, or your body is a system. So input, output, and then process. Input, process, output, this is system. So Indian system, what is Indian system? What it believes on? It is a philosophy of life. इसलिए मैंने आपको पहले मतलब पहले मिनट से मैं आपको बोल रही हूँ, इट गिव्स यू अ डायरेक्शन टू लिव योर लाइफ हैप्पीली फ्रूटफुल. एंड देन व्हेन वी कैन से दैट यस वी आर हैप्पी एंड आर लाइक वी आर एंजॉइंग आवर लाइफ, सो देर आर सर्टन नो नॉर्म्स, देर आर सर्टन गाइडलाइंस, देर इज सम फिलोसफी ऑन विच वी कैन वर्क ऑन. एंड इट इज नोन एज इंडियन इथोस इन मैनेजमेंट, दैट इज IEM. अभी आप पूछेंगे इज IEM, दैट इज इंडियन इथोस इज मैनेजमेंट, इज सम काइंड ऑफ हिंदू कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मैनेजमेंट? आंसर, इट इज रिटन ऑन योर स्लाइड, दैट इज सर्टनली नॉट, बिकॉज इंडियन इथोस और इंडियन यू नो फिलोसफी इज बेस्ड ऑन द कॉन्सेप्ट विच इज डिराइव्ड और विच इज बेस्ड ऑन all the religions those belong to this particular geography, not only Hinduism. So we are definitely not talking here about Hinduism. Yes, but that is a major religion, and their philosophies are there, guidelines, but yes, we are talking about other religions also, and we will consider the knowledge or the guidelines or philosophy which is mentioned by other religions and other culture, because we all know that we are different kind of a variety of religions, they are here, and that is a beauty of India. Like, we are learning from different cultures, and then again we say like, okay, unity in diversity. So we are diversified, we are different, there are different people there who belong to different religions and culture, but ultimately we are one. I request somebody, like somebody's mic is on. Okay. Okay, fine. So I request, if you have any questions, if you feel like I'm going fast, or if you have anything, any doubts, you can write it in the chat box, or you can unmute and then you can definitely ask questions, or you can contribute if anything you want to contribute, really, of course, related to this subject. So up to now, what we have discussed, that first from, in the beginning, we discussed about ethics and ethos. Then we discussed about the difference between ethics and ethos. Then we try to understand the meaning or the concept of Indian ethos. Indian ethos kya hai, or it is based on what? And of course, it is based on, which is related to management, or which is, what is Indian ethos is equal to Indian philosophy of living life, which is based on Indian culture. And ye culture, ye philosophy, kisne develop ki? Bahut sare religious gurus and these people, they have studied, as I said, and they have created and developed, and they have, it has some written documents are there. So let us talk about that. Here we are not here to talk about any religion, or we are not here to discuss about anything. But yes, we are here to discuss about everything which is related to Indian ethos. Fine. So let us move and understand ki bhai Indian ethos mein aise kya hai. Hum log to bol rahe ki yes, it is a philosophy which guides us, which gives us direction. So see, and then definitely I'll try to connect this philosophy, six principles which are derived from our holy books, and then definitely we'll try to understand whether they are applicable in today's management world, because we all are management student, as I said. Sirf hum log yahan pe adhyatm padhne ke liye nahi baithe. We will try to understand that what is Indian philosophy, or which are the principles which are guiding, or we can say that guiding principles of Indian ethos or Indian philosophy. Aur teesra point of discussion hoga ki kya ye hum log अभी के मैनेजमेंट में, ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल मैनेजमेंट में या ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल गवर्नेंस में उसका कोई वैल्यू है कि नहीं, बिकॉज वी ऑल आर बिजनेस मैनेजमेंट स्टूडेंट्स, एंड इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अस टू अंडरस्टैंड द the usability, applicability of all these, you know, principles. So let us understand, maybe there are many, but yes, I pick and choose six basic principles of Indian ethos. Che basic principle of Indian philosophy or Indian ethos. The sabse pehla, I'll read it, you know, all the six principles, and then one by one we will discuss. So first principle is each soul is a potential God. The second is we believe, or Indian, you know, culture or Indian ethos believes on holistic approach. And the third principle, that is equal importance of subjectivity and objectivity. We'll discuss that and we'll try to understand what is subjectivity and what is objectivity. Then karma yoga, and very interesting, yoga karmeshu kushalam. Now, what does mean by yoga karmeshu kushalam? That also we will discuss. And of course, the last principle, that is, you know, related to cooperation. So one by one. First principle of Indian ethos is each soul is a potential God. Now, what does mean by soul? It is a spark of a divine, Atma, jisko hum bolte hain. Indian ethos mein agar aap dekhte ho, to there is, and all the religions and all religious books and all holy books, they are talking about, or they discuss about this concept, that is soul. We always feel like, okay, you are individuals. Nandini ma'am is an individual, but when we are interacting with each other, or when we are connecting with each other, so I'm trying to connect my soul with maybe Gauri's soul or Maheshwari's soul, or Pooja is there, so Pooja's soul. Now, what, you know, what is what it means that, okay, each soul is a potential God. Think about it. You're not just a human being. You're not just Pooja, Nandini, and, you know, ordinary individuals. But what is that? What our, you know, philosophy says? The divine means perfection in knowledge, wisdom, and power. So we all are blessed with some kind of knowledge, and we are, you know, wise people, and we have that wisdom to know and understand this environment, or this जिसको लोग बोलते हैं वर्ल्ड, जगत को समझने की ताकत सब में दी, ईश्वर ने, परमेश्वर ने, अल्लाह ने, गुरु ने, गॉड ने, सबको दी है. सो वी हैव दैट नॉलेज, वी हैव दैट विजडम, एंड वी आर वेरी पावरफुल सोल. मैंने नहीं बोला है, सुबह सुबह का ज्ञान नहीं बांट रही हूं. इट इज देयर इन इंडियन फिलोसफी. एंड देयर फोर वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग to understand that therefore human beings are has immense potential power or energy for self-development. Hum apna uddhar kar sakte hai. We can develop in modern management, or according to modern management, yes, we are here to develop. Our first or basic instinct is development. We want to develop, we want to achieve something in our life, something good in our life. And then we are searching the solutions of our problems, the solutions of, like, okay, or the ways or the means and the direction outside. But Indian ethos kya bol raha hai? Ya Indian culture kya maan ke chalta hai? This is the first principle of Indian ethos or Indian culture. That is, you have everything. Sab kuch aap mein hai. You have that knowledge, you have that wisdom, because you are divine soul. And you have that energy of self-development. आप अपने आप को develop कर सकते हो. See, thus human efforts can achieve even an apparently impossible goals and convert the impossible into reality. आप कुछ भी कर सकते हो. ये मैं नहीं बोल रही हूँ. ये Indian ethos का एक principle है जो हम लोगों को बता रहा है कि you have full potential to achieve anything and everything in your life. तो आपको क्या करना है? The partnership of God and man can bring about extraordinary or miraculous result only if man chooses willingly to cooperate with God and actively participate in the affairs of the society by right action under his guidance and grace. So what is our understanding? Like, we can do wonders, we can bring Lawrence, we can do, you know, prosperity, we can develop. कब ऐसा हो सकता है? when you apply those principles, when you apply your learnings, when you apply your knowledge gained by Indian or gained through Indian culture. So you can achieve any goal, any impossible thing is reality. हम लोग जब एवरी इंडिविजुअल जब कनेक्ट होता है, किसके साथ कनेक्ट होने का बात कर रहे हैं हमारे इंडियन कल्चर? गॉड के साथ, दैट डिवाइन पावर. ही कैन ब्रिंग अबाउट नॉट ओनली पर्सनल डेवलपमेंट, हार्मनी, हैप्पीनेस फॉर माई सेल्फ, बट ऑल्सो प्रोस्पेरिटी टू हिज ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड द सोसाइटी विदाउट इनजस्टिस टू अदर्स. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट लाइन. किसी को हर्ट करे बिना, किसी के साथ अनजस्टिस किए बिना और इनजस्टिस किए बिना, वी कैन डू, वी कैन ब्रिंग पर्सनल डेवलपमेंट, वी कैन डू पर्सनल डेवलपमेंट, वी कैन ब्रिंग प्रॉस्पेरिटी, हार्मनी, हैप्पीनेस, एवरीथिंग. दैट इज, वी कैन टॉक अबाउट यू एज अ पर्सन, यू एज अ इंडिविजुअल. नॉट ओनली दैट, बट वी कैन ब्रिंग एनीथिंग एंड एवरीथिंग टू आवर सोसाइटी एंड ऑफकोर्स एज अ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. Now, what is based on this particular principle? Fine, that each soul is a potential God. How we can connect this particular principle in today's business environment or today's an organization? See, if you follow this principle in your life, in your day-to-day life, in your personal life, and then see what we know that what will happen to your confidence. Think about it. That if you believe that I am very powerful soul and I have that divine power, मेरे साथ एक बहुत बड़ी शक्ति है मेरे अंदर. If you believe on that, think about like, okay, we'll become more positive, you will become more confident, you are a good team player. Why? Because you believe like, okay, मैं भी कर सकता हूँ, because I have that divine power. And at the same time, when I look at others. Maybe Rucha is there, Rucha Inamdar. She's there, she's attending this lecture. So when I meet Rucha or Avinash or Omkar and Anuradha, so when we meet, then we believe, are they are also having that power. They also have that capacity to do anything and everything. So with this particular aspect, with this particular thought process, if I started working, or if I'm that kind of professional who believes on people, who believes on capacity of people, who trusts on capacities of people, just think about it. The whole perspective of your working or your interaction with people will change. I believe like, okay, Akshada, I can motivate people because I'm a self-motivated person. I believe like Akshada, you are super soul. आप कुछ भी कर सकते हो. You can do it. Come on, we will do it. And this is our organization goals and objectives. If we work in team and then everybody contributes, so nothing is impossible. Without hurting and without doing injustice to anybody, we can achieve those things. Because we believe on this basic principle of Indian culture or Indian ethos. जो हमको बताता है कि भाई तुम में वो क्षमता है. You have that. Each soul is a potential God. So you have that capacity, and then we can work accordingly. And then if you are working that energy and power, if you are, everybody is working in that direction and contributing in that direction. So therefore, we can achieve anything. Jo hum management principle mein padhe, teamwork, planning, leading, organizing, controlling and direction and other things. So we are able to do that way. We are able to achieve it. Our organization can achieve it. We can achieve it. Why and how? Because we believe on this particular principle. क्योंकि हम इस principle पे believe करते हैं. This is a guiding principle जो मैंने बताया था कि Indian ethos और Indian culture का पहला principle है ये कि लोगों पे, आपके लोगों के पावर पे, लोगों के एनर्जी पे विश्वास करो और अपने पावर पे, अपने एनर्जी पे विश्वास करो. ये मैं कर सकता हूं, ये मैं कर सकती हूं. दिस इज व्हाट अ फर्स्ट प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इंडियन इथोस. एंड दैट्स व्हाई आई सेड लाइक यस, एंड वी ऑल बिलीव एंड होल्ड वर्ल्ड एडमायर फॉर दिस. हम लोग जो बोलते हैं ना टीम बिल्डिंग एंड यू नो गोल सेटिंग एंड यू नो टेकिंग एवरीबडी इनटू इन वन डायरेक्शन एंड सेटिंग गोल्स एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव्स एंड अदर थिंग्स एंड अदर थिंग्स. So all principles, all the things which what we learn and what we discuss under in you know management, it is there. This is the first principle, is the base for your management. Yeah, I know, ma'am. I know. I'll conclude it. I know, ma'am. I'll start my lectures on time and I'll finish my lectures on time. Don't worry about that. I'll take only 1 minute and then we can conclude. So we are talking about holistic approach. So what is mean by holistic approach and what this particular principle is, and then how we can, what is our learning from this principle, which is based on Indian ethos, jo ki Indian ethos se base pe hai, uska meaning kya hai aur uska management mein kya asar karta hai ya uska organization setup pe kaisa uska hum log connect kar sakte hai, that we will next discuss in the next lecture, that is tomorrow's lecture. So thank you so much for being there, and you know, but I need some more interaction from you. I'm expecting more questions from you, and let us make it more more interesting, and let us be our you know, create a team. So thank you so much. Anything from your side, any questions? Otherwise we can conclude. Kuch bhi agar aapko bolna hai, kuch bhi suggestion dena hai, kuch bhi feedback dena hai, because we will meet every 1 hour, maybe for 12 hours or 14 hours. Ma'am has given me 12 or 14 hours. So itna time humko apna ek saath guzarenge. So if you have anything, any questions, any doubts, any feedback, feel free to ask anything. You can put it in the chat box and then I'll try to answer it. So no questions. Can we conclude for a day? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you so much, dear. What's your name?
Karan Mutha.
Okay, Karan. Thank you. Thank you for being interactive, and lot of students, that other students can interact with me. See you tomorrow at the same time. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. And thank you.
Lecture was wonderful, ma'am, and it was very much interesting.
Thank you. Who is there? Yeah, Karan again. Yeah, Karan. Thank you so much, Karan. It is really motivating, your feedback and your interaction. I'm enjoying my lectures with you, and I hope that it is a great learning. Bye-bye. See you.
Yeah. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, dear.
Thank you, ma'am.